Hello friends, today we'll see how to use the G70, G71 and G76 CAN cycle to produce this component. We know that when we are talking about the G71, it is a multiple turning cycle, or I can say the stock removal cycle, and G70 is the finishing cycle and G76 is a threading cycle. When you're talking about the G71, it means that we are going for the turning operations, whether it may be a step turning, taper turning, or a pen turning. Okay. And in G76, you can see here, you have to make a threadings. And so G70 and G76 is compulsory here to use, because it is in the problem, it is clearly mentioned that write the program to turn the component as shown in the figure and use the CAN cycle for machining this. And that's why we are using the CAN cycle here. Okay. So how to write this program? First of all, whenever we are writing the program, we have to find the coordinates. Before finding the coordinates, one more thing I would like to tell you here. Along the diametrical length, it's always a X. And along the length of the component, it will be always a Z. Second point, when the tool is moving towards your right side from the face of this component, your coordinate will be always plus. And when the tool moves towards the left along the length, then your coordinate will be minus Z. Then here, if the tool is moved away from the operator, then the coordinate will be plus X. And when the tool is moved towards the operator, at that time, your coordinate will be minus X. Now, we'll find coordinates here. I written the first coordinate as a 40 plus 2, means I'm just bringing the tool closer to the component. You know that the maximum diameter here is 40. And plus 2 means just nearer or closer to the face of the component, I have bring the tool here. Next coordinates will be 20, 0. 20, 0 means this is the, because in this, it is very clear that M20 into 1.5. So I'll tell you that what is the meaning of that. M is the matrix rates, actually major diameter. 20 is a major diameter, into 1.5 is the pitch. So the major diameter here, this diameter along this, over this component is 20. And the coordinate 0 means I'm bringing the tool at this position. The next coordinates you can see here, 20 minus 15. So diameter is 20 and along the length, you can see here, it is a minus 15. Next coordinate will be 30. 30 means again, the diameter is 30 and the length, you can see 15 plus 5, that is a 20. Now, I think you are aware why I'm writing the minus here, because when the tool moves towards the left side from this face, the your coordinates will be minus. Next will be the 30 minus 60. So here also your coordinates, you can see here, 30 means again the diameter and over the length is 40 plus 5 plus 15. Then the your next coordinate, you can see here, that is a diameter is again 40. And over the length, if you see that 40 plus 5, 45, 45 plus 5, 50 plus 15, that is 60, 65 will be the length. And after that, your legs, last coordinates will be the, again, diameter is 40, right? And the length, if you observe here, up to this, it is a 65, right? No, 65 plus 20, that will be the 85. So you have find all the coordinates, then we are given the program number here. I can just O0101, you can give any number. G40, G80, you know that G40 is a cutter radius compensation cancel. G80 is a CAN cycle cancel, means if you are running any CAN cycle before this, that will get canceled. Then G28, W0, that is a reference position of the tool. Then the G90 means we are writing the program in obsolete positioning system. G94 is the feed rate in mm per revolution, sorry, mm per minute. Then G21 means we are writing the program in metric system. M06 is a tool change, and I've taken the tool number as a 01, and this 01 is the offset value for this tool. Then M03, the spindle will start in the clockwise direction at a speed of 1500 RPM. So S stands for speed. Then you start the coolant. M08, this coolant started. Now G00X40Z2 means I have brought this tool at this position. Then next you can see here the when I'm writing the G71. Okay, can cycle, that is a multiple turning cycle. At that time, this is a standard format. And to understand, I have just written that what is the meaning of that U is nothing but the depth of cut. Because you have to remove all this material. These materials you have to remove, no? This material. Okay. So in that case, how much depth of cut? I taken the depth of cut 2 mm. So every time the 2 mm material will cut to achieve the desired size of this component. Then relief amount or tool retraction. I taken retraction value as a 1, or you can take less than 1, this 0.5. What is the meaning of that? When you are doing the turning operation, suppose you are doing the turning operation, right? Okay. Again, the tool will go back. Again, tool will come. Again, the turning will operation will take place. Okay. Retraction is tool ko piche leke jaane ka thoda se. That is the meaning of the retraction. After every cut, the tool will move 1 mm of behind or back. Then the starting block of the profile. What it means, starting block of the profile, you can see here I written the T10, means 10. You can do the 10 also or 100, any value you can do. But start of the block of the profile means yahan se program start hota hai. Yahan se hamara operation start hoga. That is called starting block of the profile. Then the next is the Q finishing block of the profile. I given the value as a Q is equal to 20. Now, in this case, the finishing, our job, or you can say the end of the block. So, yahan hamara khatam ho jayega. At the last, it will get over here. Right now? So, that will be a end block of the profile, or you can say the finish block of the profile, which is denoted by Q is equal to 20. You can take 200 also. Then the finishing allowance along the x-axis. This, if you do the facing operation at that time, the allowance is 0.1. Iska matlab ye hota hai ki jab aap turning karenge, jo depth of cut aapne liya hai, to still at the last cut, 0.1 mm material will remain here. And facing operation, you can do it. Okay. And means that is along the x-axis. If you want to give the finishing allowance in the z-axis, means yeah, z-axis means this one. How much allowances I give on the 0.2, you can do 0.1 also, mm. Now, again, the same thing. When you are going for the turning operations, okay, we are giving the depth of cut 2 mm. Now, the amounts, 0.2 amount of material will remain over this component. And in the last cut, you can take the finish cut of a 0.2. So, you will get a very good accuracy, fine finish on that component. Feed rate, 100, I have taken. Now, what we are doing here? I just gone for the G71, means same format we are using here. And I'm writing the all this value inside this format. So I've taken the U2, that is a depth of cut. R1, you know now the retraction value. Now, G71, P10, Q20, means same, I'm saying this P10, Q20, U. 0.1 and W 0.2, that is allowances along the z-axis, and feed rate is 100 mm per minute. Next, N10. See, if you take a 10 here, here also you have to put the 10. Okay, if you put 100, here also you have to put the 100. So, always, this is a very important parameter here. Now, D01 X20 Z0. You can see here. So we are from this position, the tool will move linearly. Okay. So that is a G01. Here I have taken the G00, means rapid travel of the tool, because unnecessary there is no cutting action, so we can reduce the cycle time. Now the linearly the tool will move G01, X20, Z0 means at this position. After that, next is the G01 again. This is the from this position the tool will come here. That is at 20 minus 15. After that, next you can see the again X30 Z minus 20 means you are from this position. Again, the tool will move in this position. Okay. After that, again, next coordinate will be G01, Z minus 60. You can see why I am writing this X value I have not put. Because same is the diameter. No need for the repetition. Okay. Then the next, again, X40 means here, it is a X40, Z minus 65. So diameter is 40 and already you have written the coordinates here. That is a Z minus 65. Then G01, Z minus 85. Again, the diameter remains the same. So I have not written the X as a 40 there. Directly I put the Z minus 85 here, this value. Okay. So whatever the coordinates, same thing we are repeating here in the program. Means these parameters and the coordinates, these are the very important. Then after these, and 20 G00 X50 Z5 means you can see after this the tool here the finish operation will the last operation that is a what we are called as a Q20. So finishing block of the profile will come here and the tool will move away from the component. So that's why I given the X50 Z5 is far away from the so that you can remove the job, or if you want to go for the other operations you can change the tool also. So that is a what N20. But see, as it is Q20 here, so here also you have to write the N20. Then the after this, I have to take the finish cut. You can see here the finishing allowances you are talking right now. Whether it is a finishing allowance along the x-axis or finishing allowance along the z-axis. So in that case, again the cycle will start from this position and end to this position. Now, so that is called as a G70. Here I have written that is a finishing cycle. So that is a canned cycle. Okay, G70. After that, M05. So I stop the spindle and the tool will move to its reference position. G28, U0, W0 means so jaise operations khatam ho jata hai, the tool the reference position pe chale jata. Then we have to go for the threading operation also. For that, all these formats are given. Now, these videos I have made in more details. If you go through the previous videos, you will get all the details about this threading cycle or multiple turning cycles. Here, it is again, this is a format in the CAN cycle, that is the G76 is the threading cycle. Now, M number of finish path, Jural. So, when you are threading, so at that time, how much time you are going for the finish path? So I take as a one finish path. Okay, means a small amount. If there is any bar, you can easily remove by taking the finish path. Then the next, but important thing is that always you have to put in two digits. Don't forget to write that. Okay. Then the next is the R, chamfer amount or a relief angle. I take the zero. So here, if you can write the zero or you can use some value. Mostly in we are writing the value as a zero. So the relief angles we don't want. Or a chamfering amount I have not given in the program. That's why I written the zero. After that, tool angle. So I have taken 60 degree. It depends upon the type of the threads which has to be cut on the component. So if it is a I can see the metric thread, then the angle will be 60 degrees. After that, the Q, the minimum depth in 250 microns. See, this value always should be in the micron. 250 micron means jaha humko ye pitch banana hai, right? At that case, I have taken the depth of 250. Okay. In that way, to complete these or to achieve this complete threading. Okay, so we have at one stroke or in one cut, we can't remove a large amount of material. Right now, so for that, I have taken a minimum depth of cut to 50 microns. Then the finishing allowance. Okay, so here when I'm talking about the finishing allowance, means the last cut which you are taking after making a threading, you can see we have taken the finishing path. So in the for the finishing path, 100 micron means 0.1 mm material just remain, and I can take the finish path over that. So that is called as a finishing allowances. Then the you can go for the next block here. This one X, that is a minor diameter. So there is always a major diameter, and this will be a minor diameter. So for that, I will just come back to you again, but it is in the mm. Because we need some parameters here. Thread length mm in z-axis. Z-axis, this is the z-axis. How much is the threading length here? It is 15. So I have written as a 15 mm. Then the P. Now here, P is nothing but the depth. So this is the threading depth. Okay. So this depth is a, that is called as a thread height or a depth. And here also the value should be in a micron. So for that, there is one formula. That formula is P is equal to 0.613 into pitch of the thread. So how much is the pitch in our case? You can see here, pitch is 1.5. Right now, so I written the 1.5, that is equal to 0.920 mm. If you want value in micron, this 920 microns, okay, when you convert it mm into microns. After this Q, now depth of cut in first part. See, here also I'm talking the minimum depth of cut. Here also I'm talking the depth of cut in first part. It means that when the tool move initially, jaise hum first aap jab yaha threading banana chalu karenge, to aap depth of cut jyada de do taki hamara time bache. And after that, next depth of cut, you can take the less. Okay, yaha humne 250 liya. Or you can take 150 micron. So, see, kya hoga? Hamara time bachega. Okay, so that's why the first, that is called depth of cut, were first pass. Means, yahan se pehle jo hoga aapka pehla jo threadings banayenge initially, ab isse aap jyada de sakte hain taki hamara time bache. Okay, then the feed. Now, in this case, feed is equal to pitch of the thread, which is given in mm. So, हमारे पास पिच कितना है 1.5, so I have taken the 1.5 mm. Now it's very easy to write the programs, but before that, this value you have to find out. X is equal to d minus 2 in bracket p. What is the meaning of that? I'll give. D is the major diameter. Major diameter क्या होता है यहाँ से लेके तो यहाँ तक. तो हमारा m20 जो दिया रहता है, that is the major diameter. अब p जो है हमारा this one. So how much value you are getting? It is a 0.920. Because we want this value in mm, don't put this value in microns here now while putting here. Okay. So, हमारे पास कितना आएगा? 20, that is a major diameter, minus 2 into P. तो P का value कितना है हमारा? 0.920 is equal to 18.16. इसका मतलब ये होता है कि this is the minor diameter. Okay. So, your minor diameter, we are getting the value as a 18.16 mm. Okay. Now, just after that, जैसे हमारा वो प्रोग्राम ऑलरेडी हमने मल्टीपल कटिंग साइकिल हो गया था, उसके बाद आई गिवन द नंबर एज n30, क्योंकि वहां से हमने n20 ऑलरेडी दिया था. सो आफ्टर दैट आई गिवन द n30. सो आई चेंज द टूल हियर, m06 टूल चेंज. आई टेकन अदर टूल फॉर दिस थ्रेडिंग. देन द m03 अगेन आई स्टार्ट द स्पिंडल एट अ स्पीड ऑफ 400 आरपीएम. ऑलवेज कीप इन माइंड व्हेन यू आर गोइंग फॉर द थ्रेडिंग ऑपरेशन, speed of the spindle should be as less as possible. Then the D00 X20 Z5. इसका मतलब मैंने टूल यहाँ कहा तो भी नजदीक X20 means आप देखेंगे यहाँ मैं कहा तो भी टूल लिखा होगा nearer to that. Plus Z means just away from the face of the component. After that, the here the same block, whatever you are writing here, same I'm repeating here. D76, P01, तो आपने फिनिशिंग पाथ कितना दिया? एक ही दिया. आप दो भी दे सकते हैं. 00, जहां हमने रिलीफ एंगल मैंने 0 दिया. this is a 60, is nothing but a thread, that is tool angle, that is a 60 degree, and Q 250 microns, again depth of cut humne initially kitna diya hai, 250 microns, R 100 micron, it means that finishing allowance. जैसे मैंने बताया कि आप जो फिनिश पाथ लेने वाले आप 0.1 mm मटेरियल उसमें रिमूव कर सकते हैं. देन द नेक्स्ट वन G76X 18.18. तो हमारा X वैल्यू कितना आया था यार, 18.18. आई हैव पुट दैट वैल्यू. थ्रेड माइनस 15, थ्रेडिंग का लेंथ कितना है 15, यू कैन सी आर रिटन हियर आल्सो. ओके सो दैट इज अ 15. व्हाई इट इज माइनस, बिकॉज यू आर मूविंग योर टूल टुवर्ड्स द लेफ्ट साइड फ्रॉम दिस फेस. ओके दैट्स व्हाई इट इज अ माइनस. P 920, P की वैल्यू हमको किसमें चाहिए, माइक्रॉन्स में, सो 920 माइक्रॉन्स आई पुट. Q 300, तो क्या जो फर्स्ट पास हमने बोला है 300 या 400 माइक्रॉन भी ले सकते हैं, सो आई हैव टेकन 300. एंड द फीड 1.5, सो हियर सेम वैल्यू, ऑल दिस वैल्यू आई एम राइटिंग इन दिस ब्लॉक. एंड आफ्टर दैट, आफ्टर डूइंग द ऑपरेशंस थ्रेडिंग, सो द टूल विल मूव अवे फ्रॉम द कंपोनेंट. ओके so that is a X50. तो आपने देखा यहाँ 40 है मेजर डायमीटर, तो 50 मीन्स कहा तो भी मैं यहाँ दूर लेके खड़ा कर दूंगा टूल. ओके देन द G28 U0 W0 मीन्स टूल विल मूव टू इट्स होम पोजिशन और रेफरेंस पोजिशन. देन M05 इज द स्पिंडल स्टॉप, राइट. देन M09 इज द कूलेंट ऑफ, एंड M30 इज द प्रोग्राम एंड एंड ए रिवाइंड. वन मोर थिंग आई वांट टू सजेस्ट यू दैट every time end of block you have to write or a semicolon, don't forget to write that. Now M30, so that is program it and tape rewind, means your machine is now again ready to go for the next job. Okay, so in this way we have seen that the three can cycle you use here, one is the G70, G71 and the G76. I hope that you have understand all this program. So thank you, friends.